Hello, today we are going to make a couple of sculptures. Let's start with a dragonfly. Inflate a balloon leaving about 3-inch flat tail to make the body. Twist the first soft about 1-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the first bubble in one lock twist. Twist the second about 8-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the second bubble in one lock twist. We have made the first section of the body. The loop of the second bubble should be big enough to fit the balloon through it. Twist the third 1-inch bubble, it is a connection bubble. Twist the fourth soft 1-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the fourth bubble in one lock twist. Twist the fifth about 8-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the fifth bubble in one lock twist. We have made the second section of the body. We can make as many sections of the body as we want. To make this sculpture, we can use 2 or 3 sections of the body. Let's work with 2 sections. Pull the end of the balloon halfway through the loop of the fifth and then through the loop of the second bubble. That's it, we have made the body of the dragonfly. As you can see, it's going to be quite big dragonfly. Here's a front view. I'm going to use clear color balloons to make wings. Inflate a balloon leaving up to 1-inch flat tail. Tie both ends of one balloon in one knot. Basically, I'm going to make a set of 2 wings in the shape of digit 8. Fold the balloon in half and split it on 2 even bubbles. Lock both ends of each bubble in one lock twist. That's it. Make sure both wings of the same size. Here I got it wrong, so now I have to fix it, untwist it and fix it again. For our sculpture we're going to use 2 sets of wings. The same shape, the same size. Now we have to attach wings to the body. We can use flat balloon to attach wings between section of the body. In this case, we would need 3 sections of the body. In our example, we use just 2 sections of the body. So I'm going to lock 1 set of the wings with the first bubble of the body. Fix the bubbles properly. Now it looks better. And the second set of wings we lock with the fourth bubble of the body. Yes, we have to work gently here. Try not to pop bubbles. Okay, now we just have to fix all bubbles in proper positions. Dragonflies comes in very different colors. So you probably want to use different color balloons for the sculpture. Okay, so in this sculpture our dragonfly has no legs. I think it is not a big deal. So if you want, you can always use, for example, 3 slightly inflated balloons to make 3 pairs of legs and attach them on the bottom. Now, I want to make eye bubbles. Twist 1 soft about 6-inch bubble, lock both ends of the bubble in one lock twist, cut off the rest of the balloon. We have made the eye bubble. If you really want, you can split the eye bubble on 2 bubbles. Now we fold the eye bubble halfway through the loop of the last 6 blue bubbles. Fix all bubbles in proper positions. Now we can use a permanent black marker to draw the face. There is not much to work, just big eyes, nose, smile. That's it. Bend the tail the way you like it. Congratulations, we have made the dragonfly. And now we're going to make a caterpillar using basically the same body. Inflate a balloon leaving about 4-inch flat tail. We work the body in the same fashion. This time we're going to use about 6-inch bubbles to make the section of the body. I'm going to first play this part of the video. Try to make as many sections of the body as you can using this balloon. In this example, I made 3 sections of the balloon and started the 4th section. That's when I ran out of the balloon, cut off the rest of the balloon. Attach the nozzle of the 2nd balloon, in this example I use yellow balloon, to the last green bubble of the 1st balloon. And work the 2nd yellow balloon to make as many sections of the body as you can. Cut off the rest of the yellow balloon. Attach the 3rd green balloon to the last yellow bubble. And let's make 2 more sections of the body. We can make many more sections, but I'm going to stop right here. 8 sections we have made, that's enough. For the end of the balloon through the loop of each section of the body. We work from the last section to the 1st section. Our sculpture going to have quite long tail. We can keep it, use it as a handle. I have prepared eye bubble in advance, so now we're just going to attach it, same way as we did previously. Congratulations, we have made the caterpillar. Now let's take a look at the tail. We can use it to make the head. I'm going to use this tail to make 3 bubbles. Let's twist the bubble at the point where balloon protrudes from the body. Now we twist about 1-inch bubble at the very end of the balloon. And now we split the big tail bubble on 2 bubbles of the same size. Lock both ends of the chain of these 2 big bubbles in 1 lock twist. Now we're going to lock the 1st bubble of the 1st balloon between these 2 bubbles of the last balloon. Simply force the 1st small 1-inch bubble of the 1st green balloon between these 2 bubbles. Have to work gently, try not to pop bubbles. Alright, we have made it. That is quite good looking caterpillar. I think we can use eye bubbles antennas for this side to make it really cool. For the eyes we can use whatever color balloon you like. Inflate up to 3-inch bubble. Force the bubble in the middle of the flat balloon. Make sure to make the same size flat tails on both sides of the bubble. And here's the tricky part, we have to split this bubble and 2 bubbles of the same size. Most certainly I need more practice with this. Well, everything can be done, just requires some patience. Once we twisted 2 bubbles, we can lock both ends of each bubble in 1 lock twist, or just leave it like it is. That's it. Now we can lock the eye bubbles with the last bubble of the last green balloon. Fix the eye bubbles with antennas in proper positions. Congratulations again, we have made 2-headed caterpillar. Use a black permanent marker to draw the face or faces. Using the same technique as we made the body, we can make many different sculptures. Heads, arches, parts of the body like legs, arms, and many more other sculptures. Okay, that is our caterpillar and the dragonfly. Now let's make one more caterpillar. Inflate two balloons, different colors, leaving about 5-inch flat tails. Start with yellow balloon, make one section of the body. Now take the second balloon, in this example is a purple. Twist the first purple, soft 1-inch bubble, lock both ends of the first bubble in one lock twist. Lock the first purple and the first yellow bubble in one lock twist. We're going to work both balloons at the same time, making every other body section of purple color. Twist the second and the third 1-inch purple bubbles, lock both ends of the third purple bubble in one lock twist. Twist the third yellow bubble, twist the fourth yellow bubble, lock both ends of the fourth yellow bubble in one lock twist. Lock the fourth yellow and the third purple bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the fourth purple about 6-inch bubble, lock both ends of the fourth purple bubble in one lock twist to make the second section of the body. Work the rest of the balloons in this fashion, making as many body sections as you want. I'm going to fast play this part of the video. I'm going to make 5 or maybe 4 sections of the body for this sculpture. So this is a relatively small size sculpture. Of course you can make a much longer body by adding balloons. Okay, here's the last 4th section, and the rest of the balloons I'm going to use to make the head. But first I'm going to fix all small bubbles in some color pattern. Now let's twist the 10th yellow, about 6-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the 10th yellow bubble in one lock twist. Twist the 9th purple, about 6-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the 9th purple bubble in one lock twist. The last two bubbles we twisted to make the mouth. Very well. Now we cut off the rest of the purple balloon, tie off the ends and hide them between the bubbles. For the end of the yellow balloon, through the loops of body section bubbles, starting from the last body section, going to the first body section. I'm going to fast play this part of the video. Alright, we have made the body. Fix all bubbles in proper positions. Here's the head. This time I'm going to use blue balloon to make eye bubbles, and I want to make 2 eye bubbles. Lock all ends of both bubbles in one lock twist, cut off the rest of the balloon, tie off the ends. Now we lock the eye bubbles with the last bubbles of the body. Fix all bubbles in proper positions. Use a permanent black marker to draw the face. My 3-year-old son Eric suggested to use this kind of body with red balloons to make Chuggingston train William. Twist 1-inch bubble at the end of the yellow balloon. In this example, I use orange balloon to make eye bubbles antennas. Lock the eye bubbles with the last yellow 1-inch bubble. Also, we can lock all ends of eye bubbles, orange eye bubbles, in one lock twist. Fix the antennas properly. Use the permanent black marker to draw the face. Congratulations again, we have made the second caterpillar. Let's put all the sculptures that we have made today together next to each other to get a better look. So we have made two caterpillars with two heads each of the caterpillar, and we have made one dragonfly. Have fun and happy twisting!